What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to enable SCCM branch cache within your system. So let's get right into it. All right, so enabling this feature within your SCCM server is super simple, so let's get right into it. So you're going to open up your SCCM console. From here, we want to go inside administration, site configuration, servers, and site system roles. You're going to select your server. And at the very bottom where it says site system roles, we are going to pick your DP. Now, once you select your DP, we are going to right click on it and go to properties. And right there, first tab, we are going to check off enable and configure branch cache for this particular distribution point. So enable it, apply it, okay, and you're done. Not yet. Now, next thing that we need to do is go inside your client settings. So I already have one configured and it's already deployed to my workstation. So I'm going to right click on that one, go to properties. And then from here, I am going to select client cache settings. Once you select it and give it a check mark, you're going to see on the left hand side a new option that you need to configure. So we are going to click on client cache settings. Now the first one that we need to configure, which is the most important one, is the first one, which is configure branch cache. We're going to hit the drop down menu and click yes. We're going to click on the drop down for the second option, then click on yes. Now for my lab environment, I left everything as the default, but I would say look at all the settings, talk to your network administrator, talk to your system administrator, and make the changes to fit your environment. So click OK. Once you're done, we need to deploy. So you're going to right click on it, click on deploy, and you're going to pick your collection. For this example, I did all workstations and then click OK and just give it some time. Now, that particular workstation that I pushed out, that client settings actually has an active machine, which is Office 2019. So I'm going to jump into that machine. And within here, I'm actually going to open up PowerShell. Now I'm going to run the following command. Now there's two outcomes with this command. One, it might give you an error stating that the branch cache was not installed. I don't remember what the wording is. And the second option is you're going to get a lot of gibberish, which I got the gibberish because it worked out with no problem. And that's what you should get if everything works out. Now, if you look at the active current cache size, for me, I had zero because I haven't deployed anything out as of yet when I changed this setting within my environment. But eventually, when I deploy an application or an operating system within my environment, that right there, the size zero will change within my environment, which is awesome. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video on how to enable SCCM branch cache within your server. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.